Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and I'm just doing a little bit of editing, looking at the laptop at last week's video, which was about railroad tunnels. Now, this video is about model railroad tunnels, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to make a model railroad tunnel. It's all about just trying to fool the eye, make things look real when they're not, because really, nothing's real, not even the laptop. The laptop wasn't even real. This is easy. You're gonna like this.
You gotta admit, watching a model train come out of a tunnel is one of the coolest parts of having a layout. This is from my friend Steve's layout, which we'll look at in the near future. So I'm gonna show you how to make a tunnel, how to make a portal. We'll keep it small, simple, and easy. Here we go. Alright, so I made this N-scale diorama out of styrofoam, both half inch and 1.5 inch, to kind of give you an idea of how to make a tunnel or one of the other options. And first, let's take a look at why we're doing this. So the railroad, they're coming this way, okay? But there's a mountain here. Now, option A is to go around the mountain, but there's going to be a couple obstacles. It's going to be maybe some water will be in here, or the fact that it's a curve. Now, you got to remember, railroads, especially, you know, the older railroads were built to move products fast. So when you go on a curve, you have to reduce your speed. I work as an engineer, and I can tell you, when you're in Ohio, where it's flat and straight, you can go 60 miles an hour with a freight train. But Western Pennsylvania, where there is a lot of curves, it's going to be as low as 30 miles per hour. So the railroads, they want to go straight as much as possible. And they're going to find the closest that they can get to this side by making a straight line, though. Okay, so a couple options. Now here we got the double track, because it's enough traffic to warrant double track. All right, so we got our double track through. We call this a cut. Now, you can model this as if the railroad never made a tunnel. They just simply used explosives and blasted away to have their straight line. You can model more current, where there once was a tunnel, but they blasted off the top and also made, you know, kept the track straight. But the thing is, if you're going to have it like this, you don't want to see foam. There wouldn't be foam. It would be, in the real world, most likely they're going to have a retaining wall. All right, so how do you make a retaining wall? Easy. Plastruct. I have so much of this stuff available for sale. This is HO scale cement block. Now you're saying, wait a minute, Deej, this is N scale, and you're showing me HO. Same thing, if you were making HO, I'd show you O. I like to go one scale above. I'm going to show you. Your eyes will play tricks on you. Okay, so here, when you purchase it, there's two sheets like this. Let me back up a little bit. It's two sheets, about, I think it's like 7 inches by 11 inches. The brick, or the block, see that detail. Now, end scale, yeah, there's going to be some detail, but not as good as HO. And of course, O is not going to be as good as, or I'm sorry, HO won't be as noticeable as O. But your eyes will make you believe, and I cut a piece down, that it's right. Okay, so let's just turn this here. And you can use liquid nails anytime you want to go styrene to foam. What do your eyes say? Your eyes say, hey, that looks right. So, yes, I always like to go one scale larger. And this is, of course, you know, you'll want to weather this, obviously, paint and weather the sheet styrene of brick. But that's going to be a perfect representation of what it's going to look like inside a daylighted tunnel. You'll do it on both sides. Another clever trick is to take your brick sheet and curve it. Let's see if we can fit this in here. All right, now some people, they just simply use, for the inside of their tunnel, they'll just use like black construction paper, cardboard, that type of stuff. Let's see if we can pull this off. There's going to be some practice to make sure that we can get a car in there. Now, really, you don't need this whole thing because no one's going to be able to see this far back. Really, you could actually cut it probably about here and only make it this wide if you ever wanted to do the interior of the tunnel fully around. That's up to you.
All right.
Okay. I just took some scraps of half-inch foam, and I'm showing you how a tunnel would really look. So people, I guess they automatically want to assume that if the mountain's like this, that the tunnel would be like this. Well, it wouldn't. They're going to want to keep a straight line, a straight-on portal. And they're also, you know, they're not going to put it like right here, okay? They're going to blast away as much as they can until they say, okay, you know what, we have no choice but to start it right here. So yes, let's just say the mountain, we're just going to say the mountain's 400 feet, but really maybe only 350 is in a tunnel. The other 50 feet is going to be pretty much blasted away. And then we'll make a, I'll show you how to make a portal. I love working with foam. I did not get to buy my foam cutting tool just yet. So I'll show you how I'm going to do this. I'm going to use my steak knife through here. Okay. Steak knife through here. Okay. Take this out. Okay. And now, this is going to be more realistic. I should cut a little bit. For my custom portal, I figured how wide with this line here and this line here. This is my center. And then I figured how tall I need it to be, where it's at the tightest point right here is still enough clearance for my tallest cars. And I'm just going to make a nice curve from here to here. And then I'm going to cut it out. That was pretty easy. If I can do this, you can do this. And this only cost like a couple bucks. And so, of course, I can paint it, weather it, finish the scenery, add another layer of foam on top, but let's make my track go through. Okay. Now, here's another thing. What happens a lot of times is in the 1960s, whenever the automobile and the truck started surpassing the railroad, they went to single track. but instead of having it like this, they moved it to the center. So that's my suggestion. Keep the double track portal, but make it single track through the tunnel. A lot of times also, the tunnels might have been older, and if the track was here and with these new double stacks and high cube boxcars, it may have hit. So they were like, you know what, it's just not worth it to chip away and to raise this up and raise the roof. So let's just center it, and it gives us more clearance for our taller cars. That's how you do it. So I hope you enjoyed this. Let's take a look at something else real quick. So here we see the Allegheny Valley Railroad heading over a bridge over the Allegheny River, going back to the yard. And this is part of new footage. I have so much new footage that I got to show you. So you got to subscribe to this channel, DJ's Trains. Hit the bell icon to be notified of future videos. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Please like, comment, and share. That really helps the channel out if you want me to help you out. And some other ways, reach out to me on the Patreon site. DJ's Trains, the first channel now to put augmented reality in the opening of his video. So how you like that? I'm always trying to give you guys something new, keep you on your toes. So hopefully you enjoyed that intro, along with some of the most fantastic drone footage on the internet today. But I need your help, so keep this channel going by hitting that like, comment, share, subscribe. Let's keep it going. Great stuff. Now, look how slow this train goes. It's going about 10 miles an hour, actually less than that, because it's coming into the yard. But you guys are running your trains too fast. I watched some YouTube videos of your model trains, and it looks like NASCAR. You need to slow down like the prototype. Slow and steady into the yard. You're going to love the new videos. All right, you stop watching now. Thanks.